What's up, YouTube? It's your boy Steve from Printing Gang Investments, back with another video this evening. So, Palantir was kind of flat today, just like it was yesterday. It was up a little, it was down a little. Nvidia stabilized a little bit today. SoFi is still going. That IonQ I was watching tried to pull back, man. 4% then went up. We still watching that. Some of the other plays still doing their thing. But today, I figured we should start a new segment since Palantir's flat. I talk about a lot of stocks, you know what I'm saying? And I be trying to show my positions, but I didn't necessarily know how to do it with the phone. So now that I do, I'm going to show y'all boys what we got going on, because I know a lot of you guys are long-term shareholders and you may not understand the trading and technical analysis side of Palantir, and I feel like maybe I can help you with that. So anyway, this is my trading portfolio on Palantir. I got another account where I keep like my share, my Palantir, my Nvidia, my Apple, Eli Lilly, all that shit. But right now, we're talking about trading. So these are my Palantir options. As you can see on your screen, they range from as soon as November 8th of this year, all the way out to January 16th, 2026 of next year. That's to spread out the risk. If you know anything about options, the closer the date is, the more likely you're gonna lose all your money. So, like for example, these earnings go left, that November call is through. January call, it ain't gonna be through, but it's gonna get spanked. Those other calls, those 2026 calls, they'll survive. They'll take a hit, but they'll survive, and I might add to them, depending on what price they get to. But that's what I got going on with Palantir. I got some calls that I've been holding probably since the mid to high 20s in here, the ones that are up more, like the 227%. All of these calls were really bought with profits because I've been trading Palantir calls since last year when it was 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, etc. And then, as you see, I also got a little SoFi play down here. I got a few more in another account, and I got this little Rocket Lab play. So we're going to see how those go, and I'll give you some more updates on that. But now, let's go to the chart. So this is the Palantir daily chart right here. This is one of the main charts I use when I'm buying my longer-term options on Palantir. So what do we see right here? We got some levels. Got one at like 45 all-time highs. We broke the 39 level. I drew those yellow lines. And as you can see, this is us today. Went up, went down. We kind of stayed in the middle of the range. For all my non-technical people, that's what they call a doji bar. And that means indecisiveness. It's very indecisive. I call it a hold-up candle. But right now, we're in this little range. We caused a little fair value gap to the downside. They broke it. They're trying to hold it, but we also got one to the upside. So it's not that clear on the daily. Each one of these candles are on the daily. But as you can see, if I were to wait for a dip, the main dip areas I'd be looking for on Palantir right now would be the fastest one. The quick dip would be this 42-41 area, maybe like a quick trade. But really, the good dips would be this 39 area down here where this green block is. It's called a fair value gap. I like this 39 down to like 37, 90, 38. And if we fall, we got an order block, which it might hold even stronger. And that goes from 37 all the way down to 36.41. So, you know, if you're impatient, you could get the top of that range at 39. If this happens and you really think we could crash, you can go all the way down like the 36s. But anywhere in there, I would load up. And under that, we got this big fair value gap in the 33 to 31 area. More support in 29s and 30s. I'd be selling everything loading up if we fail there. And it wasn't because the company fucked up. Now, if the company fucked up and we down there, that's a different story. But if the market knocks us down there, I'm going crazy. And the reason I like to do stuff like this, because you see this right here? That was the August dip. I bought that. That's why one of them calls up some hundreds of percent now. When you catch these areas and the dips of these areas and you catch it on that dip, you make good money. I ain't gonna lie, people. You make good money. So right now, We sitting here consolidating on the chart. The chart's kind of saying the same thing we seeing. We waiting for earnings. We waiting to see how earnings turns out. You know what I'm saying? And then we're going to see if we're going to get our up move or our down move. Also, we'll show you guys the 4-hour chart. You know, when you're doing technical analysis, you like to look at different time frames. So this is the same as our other chart, but every candle represents 4 hours this time. You feels me? So what we got on the 4-hour? We are in a consolidation zone. They're giving us a little more stuff to look at, but it's still a lot of doji candles. They got this little fair value gap of support. It's that 41-42 area I was telling you about. I'm going to be watching that to see if it holds. And the top of the range, we know the top of the range is all-time highs. It's basically saying the same thing. We got to wait for earnings, people. There's nothing really to do. There's nothing really to do until earnings. We got fair value gap 41-23 and the 39 area. Same ones from the daily, man. Same ones from the daily. So that's where we at on Palantir. We really just technically we're doing the same thing we doing macro wise. We're sitting here waiting on earnings or macro event to crash the market. If a macro event crashed the market, it might be time to load up. But you know, I was just trying to, you know, do something new. Just try and show my portfolio instead of just talking every day. Let me know how you guys like this video. If you would like more of that, let me know. My phone up here talking about the E. coli McDonald's outbreak. So don't none of y'all eat no McDonald's tomorrow. It's your boy Steve from Printing Gang Investments. I'm out.